You want to yell action?
No, no, no. Yalitza es buenísima. Tú tienes que ir a acción cuando tú digas.
¿Acción?
Eso.
Was there this enormous pressure because the movie is so personal?
Well, yeah. I mean, I didn't feel that in the early days while I started shooting because you're in such a pragmatic mode that you don't stop for a second to reflect. But eventually, when the realization came to me of what I was doing, it was intense.
How long have you been wanting to tell this story?
Consciously, it was 12 years ago when I tried to put together the film for the first time, but probably had been going in an unconscious way. I lived with it for a long, long time. And but it was not until 3 years ago that I decided, okay, I have to stop like fooling myself. I have to do this.
And did you always know it would be in Spanish and black and white?
Yeah, that was part of the seed of the, I mean, it didn't make sense not to be in Spanish. You know, that would have been no point of it. But also, no point of doing Spanish and Mixteco, that is this other language. And black and white was the same thing, was part of the DNA. From when the idea manifested, it was already in black and white.
No, nunca leí el guión completo.
Actually, I never read it because he didn't want to give it to us. No, I'm just kidding now, but we didn't have the script at all. So, well, at first, when I heard that I was for the role, that I was going to play the role, I couldn't believe it. I didn't understand what was going on. But then after a little while, I realized what was going on, and I was very happy about it.
Nunca había actuado más que para engañar a mi mamá.
Never just to fool my mom.
Pero no.
Never acted before and never even thought about being able to be in a film with such great people.
It was a long, 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 long process of casting, months and months. First in Mexico City, and then we decided to, as we were not finding what we were looking for, we decided to start looking in the state, in the region where the real person whose character, the character of Cleo is based upon, she comes from. And so we start searching in the state of Oaxaca, that is in the south of the country, south of Mexico. And we have this army of casting crews going through different villages until we were so lucky that we bump into Yalitza's life.
I was invited for an audition by Luis Rosales, who is the casting director. It was just about talking about myself. That's all I did the first time. And then there were like more auditions. It was a process of, I think it was like 4 months. And until the end, I knew who was going to be the director of the film. I didn't know it before. So it was really amazing story. And I met Alfonso at the very end of the process.
The actors who were going to play these real life people, these real life characters, they had to look alike or as much alike as the original ones 50 years ago, but also they had to feel like them. You know, so there was the reasoning which it was such an intense and such a long process of casting. Sometimes you would meet with amazing actors that they were not that they were not this character. And I was so lucky with, I remember the day that we met, mm-hmm. And because I was desperate. At that point, I was desperate, thinking, okay, I'm not going to find this, I'm not going to have find the actor for Sofia. When Marina came into the room, and I have seen already videos, but when we start talking, it was immediate. It was immediate that she was Sofia.
I think a lot of people are going to ask if she learned from you, but did you learn from her?
No. I learned from her. And that's the only answer to that question. Wow. Absolutely. For me, it was, I think for her, it was really easy. There's something about her that she just flows. And I had to like connect with that. She helped me a lot.
And because the actors didn't have a screenplay. Well, nobody had the screenplay. I had a very precise screenplay, very detailed, but nobody read it. Not the crew members, not the actors. And we shot in absolute sequence. And they were learning their circumstance every single day. My family has seen it. And there's been a lot of crying. The real life Cleo, her name is Libo. When she watched the film for the first time, she was just weeping. And I went to hug her. And at some point feeling if I had crossed a line and maybe talked something too intimate for her. And when I mentioned that to her, she couldn't care less about that. She was just concerned about the children in the film.
I just want to tell you that of all your movies, which you know everyone loves, this group is the biggest fans of The Little Princess.
Oh, well, me too. That's the one of the ones I've done that I really, really love.
I think you may have said that it's, I don't know if you said favorite, but one of your...
Well, I don't know favorite. I don't see them ever since I finished them. You know, so I have just an amazing memory of that period of shooting A Little Princess, and my son was there, 20 little girls, and it was fantastic.